They snap it at one. Now it's Jackson. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
This is Hunter. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get it behind the line. 2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
A rare misstep on that last play, because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Now it's Jackson. Throw left side, complete. That's Joseph. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Here's Hunter. Down right around the 25. A tackle made by JT Woods.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Here's Jackson. Touchdown, Jets! 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Jets have taken the lead.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field, and that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
The Charger drive about to get going. After that last score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football game. And the Jets pressure, two marches, down he goes. Flying in to pick up that sack, Jordan Brooks.
He only gave them an instant to react. It was a classic case of if you blink, you missed him. Off of the line and to the quarterback in just a couple of seconds. Running back only had a moment to react and attempt to throw a block.
Throwing on second and long.
Herbert.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. They push him back 8 yards that time on second down.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. Trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Julian Love picks it, and the Jets are going to take possession of the football. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
And it's another OSCE, because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. OSCE tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week, because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week, he got the OSCE, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. And they'll run it with Hunter. And he gets it a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get his second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. Second down and goal. Jackson. This is caught. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Jackson will keep it. Only a few inches needed on the sneak. He didn't get it, and now it's fourth down. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. A great play there. His 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Jets' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And it's now 21-7. Chargers 7. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guy
looking for Pettis, but that's intercepted. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Jet touchdown. A big play there by the rookie. An interception followed by the return for 6 points.
If you want to be accepted by your teammates and coaching staff, make plays like that.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. Now, they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Herbert. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on first down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
Now movement up front. I think they're going to get one of the Charger linemen. Rashawn Slater, first-round pick in 2021, guilty there. So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, third and long. Gun, Herbert. He finds his target, Allen. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down. They'll run for it with Eckler, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
Herbert's throw there complete to Allen.
Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit, and they get one here in the passing game.
Nowhere to go for Herbert, and he's going to go down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
So that now four first-half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
And partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's the game plan that they've had so far, because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Herbert. He's airing it out for Williams. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here.
An attempt at a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage.
Final shot before the break for Herbert. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And the tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon.
The Chargers going to get the football first here in this second half, and they trail as we get back underway. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. Well, they look up at the scoreboard facing that deficit. A three-score game, Charles, but look, there's plenty of time to go here. The old football cliche that comes to my mind is you can't get it all back at once. They probably need something, though, out of this drive, at least 3 points.
Are you trying to say that there's no three-score drive on that play sheet for any of those coordinators? They just don't have it, right? You're trying to get it all back. You know you can't get it back in one drive, but maybe cut into it a little bit, as you just suggested. Try and create a little bit of momentum, a little bit of a spark, and then maybe that'll carry over.
Looking to throw on second down. Herbert. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
The frustration is definitely setting in, because they've thrown it to him over and over, unable to come up with a catch thus far.
I think he knew he would have his challenges against the secondary. I don't think he saw a goose egg at this point in the game. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now movement up front. I think they're going to get one of the Charger linemen. Ooh, moving from his tight end spot there.
Do you think that perhaps the play call was for him?
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters, as they'll try again now, third and long.
Three. shotgun snap for Herbert. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
A gain of 19 yards. And the Chargers first down. First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Herbert on first down now. Williams brings it in. Touchdown, LA! Mike Williams, 60 yards. And the Chargers get a bit closer. On is Hopkins now for the extra point. It's up and good, and it's now 28-14. Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Jets take over first and 10 at their own 21.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
And you can say that again. They've got to be pretty
down the numbers. There he goes. He's at the 30. 10. And he takes it into the end zone across the chalk. Now there is a flag down, but I think that's offsides on the defense.
Yeah, I think that's going to stand, partner.
Gonzalez to have the PAT. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Chargers 14. Zane Gonzalez set to.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. What a play that turns out to be. 36 yards.
And this offense needed something to try and seize the momentum a little bit. That might have been exactly what they needed. Now they have a chance to go downfield and score and cut into the lead.
In motion left goes a tight end. Herbert off of play action. Quick slant complete to Keenan Allen. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
To Keenan Allen. 8 yards on the pickup. Brings us to
on second down, Eckler. And he'll go down at the 28. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down. Another modest gain there on that one. And I think, Charles, you can probably pin part of the deficit on a failure on their part to really get this ground game established.
Yeah, they've really struggled to be multidimensional in this one.
Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes the sack for a loss of 6 to bring up second down. Another try after the first down sack. Herbert throws left side complete to Keenan Allen. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line. The play fake, and now Herbert to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first down, Justin Herbert. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. Now a second down and six.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six. It's got 6 yards left.
Herbert now. And he's in for a Charger touchdown. A great effort there. A beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Chargers are able to cut into that deficit.
This is why a lot of play callers love play action in this spot. You just want to freeze the linebackers just for a second. Then you got a chance to...
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And he's got it in the end zone. And it's a classic ball here down by as many as they are. But the fake works. And they'll get 2 points closer instead of one. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a 1st and 10. Play action. Now Jackson. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. 2nd and 19. To throw is Jackson. He's going to wind up and air it out. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes, you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
Joseph, and he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. 3rd and 19, no problem as they're able to convert.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the 3rd quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Kenneth Murray, give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. 3 quarters have come and gone. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. 2nd and 24. Here's Jackson to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side.
And oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances, putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, 4th quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been.
And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need.
Picked off by Asante Samuel Jr., and the Chargers are going to take possession of the football.
Now with that interception, you feel like we've got a ball game again. Remember, 2-score contest and still time left here in the 4th.
And in the old days, not too long gone either. Throwing the ball here would have been an absolute no-no, but the way the game's played now, throwing it makes sense. You just have to be careful when you put it in the air.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Well, they approached this drive with a lot of confidence after the last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
Play action. It's Herbert. He's got a man. That's Keenan Allen. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Play action this time for Justin Herbert. Give him another one right back to Allen. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Bring him down after just a short pickup. Give him 40 on the gain there. Second and goal.
Every team we ever talk to that continues to run the ball in a game, even when they haven't had much success, all talks about attrition, don't they?
And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. The sneak successful for the yard out. And the Chargers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Here's Hopkins now for the extra point. And the lead will shrink to six. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this one. To the 25-yard line. Offense coming up now to start their next drive. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, 100%.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. And the Jets add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Jackson here is going to look to throw. And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play, factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25.
Hey.
The Charger drive about to get going.
And as the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again, but we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
Yeah, we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. Into the hands of Williams across the formation.
And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets' 44-yard line. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Over the middle, he finds Pettis complete. And he comes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Herbert setting up to throw on first down. Dancing to his left. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, it looked like a march to the end zone is in a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. This throw caught right around the six. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Here's Herbert. Eluding the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Oh, that's good decision making right there. Understood down and distance. Knew it wasn't third down, and he still had another opportunity to earn the first down. Good job throwing it away and avoiding an interception.
Second and goal. Herbert. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Julian Love. And the Jets are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line.
Well, and field goals probably aren't going to cut it at this point. This was touchdown or bust, and unfortunately for them, it turned out to be bust.
Yeah, they're feeling like they've got to force the issue here, maybe take some chances they wouldn't have earlier in the game. But give credit to this defense. They've really stood tall throughout. And they come up with the interception in the end zone.
They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. And the Jets first down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. Now Jackson on first down. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. He finds his man complete. It's Joseph. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Here's Jackson. Going up top. And it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And the Chargers are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
two-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy, because with a two-score lead, you think maybe just sitting on it, trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good
call. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Caleb Farley, and the Jets will take over possession here up at the 34. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math, but it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it, but the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. They're in some hot water now after that sack. It's 2nd and 21. They go play action with Jackson. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. Touchdown! Chigakonkwo, 67 yards. And the Jets have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Gonzalez now to add the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21 points.
Makes the score Jets 50, Chargers 29. Gonzalez set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Back to throw here, Herbert. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailing by multiple touchdowns and a late sack. Just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the
line. Under pressure, and they got to him again. Multiple rushers break through to drop him for the 7th time this game. And as this defense walks off the field, they should do so with their heads held high. What a performance by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides of the football here in this one.
Certainly was, and I think both sides compete against each other all the time. You go to each other in practice, obviously your training camps, your offseason. But on game day, you both want to show your best. And I think that's what we saw for both the offense and the defense, a complete team victory.
So for the Jets, the win will move them to 7-2 now on the year.